question number 4 and to draw quadrilateral LMNO, and to our surprise the question is same as that of Bark, if you observe, right? One diagonal, that is OM, and four sides are given to us. So to make us some easier, we will be drawing OM first. From OM, I'm gonna locate point O above the segment OM, and I'm gonna locate point N below segment OM. How I'm gonna locate? Now I'm gonna take 6 cm distance in the rounder, keep the middle tip on point O, draw the arc above. Same thing, without changing distance, I'll keep the middle tip on point M, draw the arc above, and then intersection will be point L. Voila! And this is the intersection joined towards the point O and M, and sides are found, right? Now only fourth point is remaining, that is point N, right? It will be drawn or located below segment OM. So same thing, take distance 4.5, draw the arc from point O, point M, and the intersection will be point N, and construction will be completed. I hope you understood, because it's the second time we are doing, right? So let's do it practically. So as per our plan, we are going to draw diagonal OM first of all. Always keep it in mind, when one diagonal is given, we draw the diagonal only first of all. The 7.5 is drawn properly. While drawing this segment, boys and girls, again keep it in mind, don't miss even half mm too. The next thing we have to do, we will plot point L above the segment OM, the way I informed you, by taking the distance 6 cm, because OL and ML are same in length. Now the intersection of these two arcs is nothing but point L, and that is already marked by me. After that, below the segment, we are going to mark point N, and for that we will take distance 4.5, because ON and NM both are equal and it is given 4.5. Draw the arc, and the intersection of the arc is nothing but point N, the way it is shown to you all. The last step is to join the segment, that is OL and LM, similarly ON and NM, and then your quadrilateral is ready with the proper measurements and all. After completing the quadrilateral, do not forget to mention the values of the sides onto it, and remember the shortcut. Whenever one diagonal is given and remaining sides are given to you, we begin with the diagonal itself. Don't forget it. Now here we are with the third question of 8.1, and to draw ABCD, and this time three angles are given to us and two sides are given. Okay, so you can choose any one side in which two angles must be present, right? Okay, you can choose any one, because ABC are three points and all three angles are given to us, right? So I'm going to choose the longer one, that is AB. After drawing AB, I'm going to draw angles, right? From point A, 70 degrees somewhere like this. Accounting will be beginning from the right side, 0, because B is on right side. It will be somewhere like this. From point B, I need to draw 50 degree. Here it is. After that, I'm going to locate point C by taking distance 4.8 in the rounder. Draw the arc on that arm, and that arc is nothing but point C. From point C, now I'm gonna keep protractor, okay? Exact center point of the protractor will be on point C. Arrange it in such a way that reference line will be overlapping this segment BC, right? And B is downward, so downward 0 you will use to begin the counting, right? So 140 will be located somewhere here, and to your surprise it will intersect the ray starting from A, right? That is angle A, and that will be the point D. And this is the rough diagram. Now I hope you have understood the structure, the pattern of working, and now let's move on to do it practically.
As per our rough diagram, we are going to draw segment AB first of all, that is 6.4 cm, the way we are looking. After that, we will draw angle A equals to 70 degree, the way it is given in the question. Keep the protractor's center point on vertex A and try to overlap the reference line exactly on the segment or the side AB, the way you are looking in that screen now. Once you feel that the overlapping is done perfectly, only then you proceed further to count the angle. Now here A is the angle I need to draw and point B is on right side. So from right side 0 I will start counting. The counting is done, 70 degrees marked and the marked location is joined with vertex A. Now we will draw second angle, that is angle B. For that again protractor will be kept on point B. Center of the protractor is on vertex B. Reference line is overlapping and point A on the left side. So from left side 0 I will start counting and angle 50 is marked. After marking that angle 50, I need to draw that marked location to vertex B. Be very careful while joining these locations, that is marked location and the vertex B. Now after this we will try to locate point C on the arm B. Okay, for that the length BC is given to me. Now my work is to take that distance BC in the rounder. After taking that distance properly, keep the metal tip on B afterwards and mark its distance on its arm. So over here the distance is taken properly. Once distance taken, keep the metal tip on point B and mark its location on that arm of the B. Now that is point C, distance is 4.8, and now from point C the third angle, that is 140 degree, we need to draw. Now this time keep the protractor again properly so that reference line will match BC. B is on downward side, so downward 0 will be counted by us. So from that 0 counting will begin from the down 0 towards the B side. Yes, exactly. And now check where the 140, and the 140 is marked. That marked location of 140 will be joined to vertex C, and the moment you join to that vertex C, you will observe that it is intersecting with angle A, and that intersection is nothing but vertex D. And in this manner we have completed the diagram by locating point D also.
Boys and girls, this is second question of 8.1. I need to draw quadrilateral DEFG and two diagonals are given to me, right? DF and EG. Construction is very easy. What we are going to do, we are going to draw DE first. Okay, why? You can choose any one of them. I chose DE. I felt like that. That is why. Okay. What I'm going to do now, see what to check. Now two points are already located by us, only two points are remaining. Which are those two points? One is F, another one is G. So what I'm going to search in this list, how many sides do we have with point F? One is EF, okay, and one is DF. So what I'm going to do, EF is there, right? Point E is there with me over here. So 6.5 distance will be taken in the rounder. Keep the point metal tip on point E and then draw the arc. Now after drawing that, take distance DF, keep the metal tip on point D because D is available from those DF, and draw the arc. Those arc will intersect somewhere here with the point F, and that intersection is nothing but point F. Now as point F is located, now time has come to locate point G. G is over here, right? Two sides are DG and EG. So I'm gonna take distance DG in the rounder 5.5 and keep the metal tip on point D, because from DG point D is available, right? Metal tip is kept on point D, the arc is drawn, and somewhere here it will be there, right? After that, from E I need to draw 7.8, right? I will take distance in the rounder 7.8, I'll keep metal tip on point A, and then again draw the arc. These arc will intersect somewhere here with point G, and then you have to just join these two points. After that, only one thing is remaining, that is to join GF, and once you join it, your quadrilateral is ready. Isn't it easy? Yes.
So for the quadrilateral DEFG, we are going to draw segment DE first. Don't forget to take proper distance, that is 4.5. and after drawing DE, we are going to take distance 7.2 in the rounder to plot point F and D from point D and E respectively. So distance DF is 7.2, so 7.2 arc is drawn. Now we are going to draw EF. For that we'll take distance 6.5 very cautiously, carefully. Now lift the metal tape and keep it on the point A and mark the arc. So that gives you point F's location. Okay, after that we have to join those points so that segment DF, that is diagonal actually of that quadrilateral, and segment EF, that is side of that quadrilateral, is drawn by us. Now we will try to locate point G. For that we will again take distance DG, mark it properly 5.5, and then take distance 7.8 in the rounder, keep it on E for the distance EG, and mark the location for point G. Once the distance is taken carefully, keep the metal tip on point E and mark it. That intersection gives the point G, and now our work is to join those points DG and AG. DG is nothing but side of that quadrilateral, EG is the diagonal of that quadrilateral, and once these are joined, now last work is to join segment GF also, that is side GF, and then my quadrilateral is completed. Don't forget to mention the values of side in the diagram. I hope you understood it.